If you told me 9 months ago I'd be sat in a puddle with one of Singapore's rising creators, I would have laughed in your face. But if you had the chance to fly across the world, meet a stranger, and visit a country you knew nothing about, would you do it? Or would you fold under the pressure, find an excuse, and exist?
He's gonna get there.
Zacc Chen is a modern-day entrepreneur with over 10 million combined views, combined followers, YouTube video underrated, overrated, upcoming, inspiring human. He's a human who invited me into his home and showed vulnerability. It's always a risk going on an adventure with someone you don't know, but as soon as I met Zacc, we both clicked into place.
I don't want to block you from being in the show at the same time.
We have a one-way flight.
Like, we have a one-way flight.
I don't think there's any other, like, it's the most winging it, like, we don't even have any accommodation booked.
Yeah, we actually don't.
We're technically homeless for the 5 days at the moment.
On the real, we're homeless.
We're flying there on the one-way.
Being homeless in Taiwan,
dude, that is insane.
With Zacc Chen.
It didn't matter who we were. Our race, our past, our personality, we shared the same dreams. And we were willing to do whatever it takes to reach them.
When I die, fuck it, I wanna go to hell. If I'm a piece of shit, it ain't hard to fucking tell. It don't make sense going to heaven with the living when he's dead.
Flying into a country notorious for its underground vice, a country brave enough to tell China to fuck off.
No sleeping all day, no getting my dick lit.
Should be terrifying to two outsiders, but I was addicted to living on the edge of my seat, comfortable in the uncomfortable. And Zacc, I'd never met anyone who could keep up. I felt like I was chasing him.
I know I dream about her all day. I think about her with her clothes off. I'm riding around with my system pumping LS.
I found someone who moved quicker than me, but maybe I was slowing down. 4 days until my 1 year adventure across the globe ended, I was beginning to feel this in my gut.
Right now we're in Taiwan, and I'll be so real, this is gonna be my takeover part of Zacc's vlog. It's gonna be the first ever behind the scenes, and I think you guys are really gonna enjoy it.
Let's go, baby!
Welcome to the jungle, boy. So today we're in Taiwan.
Traveling these lands with someone who spoke fluent Mandarin opened this foreign world up to me. We'd embrace the flash of Taiwan's capital and learn to travel with each other seamlessly. All the world's creatures were born of nature, not concrete jungles. No matter the artificial development, if you want to feel alive, you must plummet into the wild. And if you want to see a country's open heart, you must go off the track. Girls with pigtails shooting machine guns, to turtles given away as prizes at carnivals, to octopus tentacles being fried in bowls of boiling hot water, to fire up your neural pathways and to stimulate your mind, to feel and learn. We'd become oblivious to the stairs. We enjoyed people's confusion as they pondered over this curious duo far from home. And we heard of this mountain with a crisp blue lake and marble walls, untouched and incredibly out of reach for two outsiders. But we had this magnificent energy bouncing between us, pushing each other to dream a little larger. So we took the most difficult route there.
Now who the fuck called me a player? I ain't one of these young niggas.
teach these bitches how to lay up?
Bro, literally, like, one of my biggest fears is dying without seeing stuff like this. Like, I think that's what we have in common as well. Like, that's why we want to do these trips, because I would be so scared that I've died and there's stuff like this on the planet that I just haven't seen.
It's because we've been in the city, bro, and now we're out here, bro. You're nature boys, bro. I told you, bro, the city's too much.
That's actually why I did my whole year of traveling. That's it.
I feel like if this is the crescendo of like the year of traveling, it's like, I don't know that much about your reason of starting to go on this trip, but now you know the reason why you've like ended it. Like you have a new purpose in life.
Yeah. You literally, bro.
Yeah.
It's insane to say that.
Like, you don't know why you started, but looking back, like, you know why now you're leaving.
The last 2 days before I go home, I'm going home with a new purpose. And I understand why I left. That's crazy, bro.
Very few men are actually alive, bro.
Very few men are actually alive. That's crazy.
I was reaching the peak of my trip, the highest of the highs. People flashing and countries blurring, not remembering who I used to be and ignoring where I came from. But what goes up must come down. And this trip with Zacc was like sticking the flag at the summit of the mountain, a long way down. I saw my family home for the first time in 8 months. A warm flow ran through my body as my eyes settled on the familiar. Complete calm. With no planned escape this time, it finally felt like an end. No one mentions how easily you slip back into an old rhythm. Whilst my mind danced with the memories of mountains, my eyes dealt with the mundane. It felt beautiful to belong, to be a long-term character, to be known by people around me.
The glue on my trousers as well, it's all going wrong.
These are from Japan. Cool, you don't care, do you?
But my heart hadn't returned yet, it was in denial. I felt 17 again, itching to leave my hometown. Life was big and I felt I was ignoring it. Confusion, sadness, and a masked smile took control of my body. There's no happy ending yet. No epiphany. I'm struggling to settle back in. My daydreams of beaches, rivers, and jungles felt exactly that. Dreams, like I never really left. I've never been more confused with what happens next.